thing.
I've been calling this comp so many times. Outlaw Frost, all the people play Sabrok. This is it. Watch this game.
Yeah.
Watch this and
this
respect.
This is
going
to be very interesting. And you wouldn't have expected Tempo Storm to be the one to actually bring it out. Botar on the Priest, Alec on that Frost Mage, and Nixie on the Outlaw Rogue.
XRB to the moon. They're having their PTSD about Waz's Pirate Rogue from all of last expansion. Nixie trying to get a surprise attack here with a composition we haven't seen yet. Outlaw really not showcased at all. It's just annihilating Z-Pi at the moment. Huge amounts of pressure throughout this. Hovering very low. Looney still crowd controlled. However, Z-Pi is starting to restabilize, and as that crowd control ends, of course, Looney will connect heals and save the day. Tempo Storm at the back of that attack, even though it was a lot of pressure, didn't actually result in anything too significant.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, considering I don't think any of us expected Tempo Storm to lead with the Rogue Mage Priest here, especially not the Outlaw, this is something that Zico's been talking about, and I can see his face very excited about throughout the entire season. Outlaw is back, but XRB to the moon, once again, showing they're a very well veteran team. Even with this kind of curveball thrown at them, they answer it very excellently at the start of this one. We can see Botar, of course, going to be the target of choice for the Turbo Cleave. Now we need to see Tempo Storm getting aggressive somehow. They need to get something going here, Seb.
Warrior Enhancement Shaman are probably the best two classes together to kill a Disciplined Priest, so that's going to be the high priority target for XRB to the moon, is get as much uptime on Botar as possible. They can force the most amount of mana usage, they can force the most amount of cooldowns, and probably kill him. But the risk of that is that Botar can, of course, outposition his opponents, such as this, by dragging in Blizzo and Z-Pi out of line of sight of Looney. Looney can't heal them, and they fall behind. So it is a risky, high-value decision to go after Botar. And right now, it seems to be paying off. XRB trading Trinket for Blind. Fair play from Looney. I'm curious to see if they may look for a cheeky swap to Looney in the future. They could punish that Trinket usage. So far, XRB to the moon, as we expect them to be, are a brick wall. I'm curious to see if Tempo Storm are going to find a way around them.
Yeah, they're really struggling. It looked like a great setup there with the smoke bomb and everything from Nixie, but they didn't force a single Trinket on the DPS. They didn't force Astral Shift, so really nothing doing. Blizzo once again caught up in the stun, but XRB to the moon are just all over this game right now. The only kind of thing that's going okay for Tempo Storm is that the manners. Even Botar's been doing a fantastic job buying his team time, but at the same time, he's also used a lot of his defensive coins. The pain suppression's down, the Rapture active right now. He's starting to drop low on mana, and this is something that XRB to the moon love to do. They love to whittle their opponents down, just survive long enough. Now we see a big swap coming over onto Looney, though, Sid.
Yeah, that swap is what I was expecting from Tempo Storm. It was really the only clear open target that they had, and they managed to pull Barkskin from Looney, so now they've got a 53-second window to set up another one of these swaps. They got Z-Pi's Trinket. If they get that double Psychic Scream and switch targets, Looney is going to be incredibly vulnerable.
Yeah, I mean, Looney is the best target of the situation. We have the Barkskin, we have the Trinket down on him. One of the things I do want to call out is Z-Pi is actually playing every single thing defensive. He has three stacks of the Azerite Fortification trait, which basically means whenever he gets stunned, rooted, crowd controlled in any form, he's going to get a big heal from that, meaning that he has a lot of sustained. In addition, he's also playing the Veiled Eye Trinket that we've known from the last couple of tournaments as well. So
here it is.
Defensive, but this is the swap over onto Looney. Big damage coming out late. Good defensive fear. Is it going to be enough? DR cheap shot. They're looking for the kill. Here comes the Iron Bark. Looks like Looney might be able to escape because of those peels from Blizzo.
The Polymorph on Z-Pi was just a little bit too late, and as soon as that Enhancement Shaman gets out of crowd control, he's going to be pumping a ton of heals. They make a swap to Blizzo. He's caught in a stun. Barely getting that dive by the sword off on 10%. Looney struggling to pick him up. I really like the plays from Tempo Storm. Switching targets, trying to go after the most vulnerable, going after targets that don't have that Gladiator's Medallion to get out of crowd control. It's smart play by Tempo Storm, but XRB to the moon, they stay alive, and the longer they do so, the more uptime they get on Botar, the further ahead they ultimately will be. If we take a look at the Gladiator's Medallion situation right now for XRB, Looney is now no longer the most vulnerable. His is available. Z-Pi, on the other hand, he's in a 20-second window. If we look at Nixie, he has Smoke Bomb in 10 seconds. There's a 10-second window right now where they can either kill Blizzo or Z-Pi, but Tempo Storm need to execute cross crowd control, which means crowd control on all three members at the exact same time so that they can't assist each other. If Tempo Storm can initiate that, they've got an opening. 50 more seconds, and at this point, they likely have to do it on Blizzo. They're trying to squeeze it in here on Z-Pi, but they don't have it, and this is smart play by Alec. Hold on to the ice form. Blizzo has to be the target to take down. XRB to the the Moon need to prepare to protect Blizzo.
I mean, I'm starting to wonder if they can just win this game by attrition. Tempo Storm are playing fantastically. Botar is the only Discipline Priest I've seen go up against XRB to the Moon and live until
this dampening. Is the smoke bomb.
Now comes the smoke bomb. This is a lot of damage on Blizzo. Those Z-Pies in it will be able to get out those heals. But look at the mana. As soon as Innovate disappears from Looney here, he's basically going to be out. And now we see the full stun coming over. Z-Pie should be low on mana. Still able to get the heals out onto Blizzo. Trinket on Blind is something we expect here from Looney. So he's going to have that. But look at the mana situation. Botar's been doing so fantastically well on just kiting, using those Frost Mage slows. And he's actually up right now, slightly said.
All right. The next game-winning play here is going to be Blind for Nixie as Outlaw. You can talent to have 30-second cooldown reduced Blind, which means it's a minute and a half. Gladiator's Medallion is 2 minutes. That's a 30-second window where you normally can't Trinket Blind against Outlaw. But Z-Pie and Blizzo both have their trinkets, so Tempo Storm are going to just have to hammer down with tons of damage when Looney is in that blind. If they don't have the tons of damage, then they're not going to find the kill. It's the end of its rope at this point. Both healers are out of mana. Cooldown window is more in favor of Tempo Storm. They're actually making a swap to Looney, trying to go after the most vulnerable, the target that doesn't have Gladiator's Medallion, and they might be able to squeeze it in. 5% remaining HP. Looney hovering. He manages to stay alive, but at the expense of the rest of his defensive arsenal. When Dampening gets to this critical mass and the healers are tapped on mana, you have to expend more cooldowns than you otherwise would. Now they switch to the other most vulnerable target, Blizzo. Tempo's targeting decision in this match has been perfect. This is the Rogue Mage
thing, but now the difference is going to be Dalaran Arena, a smaller map, so that's going to favor XRB a little bit better.
Now let's take it a step further, though, and really think about how crazy it is to think about that team that's been split up. You got Botar, Blizzo, and Swapsy all on three of the favorite teams to potentially win BlizzCon, and Fabs is just waiting on an island right now, and he goes, yeah, if anyone catches up to me with the three BlizzCon wins, maybe I'll team with you again.
Yeah, and I mean, we see it once again here. Tempo Storm, the only team that could beat them last year at European Regionals was Method Triforce, and guess who was the healer on that roster? It was Botar. Now he's back, but the other person we should talk about is Blizzo, of course, who was on that killer roster, and he has been on fire this season. Great peels coming out once again here to deny any setup onto Looney.
So Looney has made a strategical change here. He knows that the Blinding Powder reduces the cooldown of Blind, and he can't Trinket it every time. So instead of running Gladiator's Medallion, he's running Relentless, which just reduces all incoming crowd control, but he can't break them immediately. It just reduces the duration. Now the risk with this is if he gets stunned out of bear form, he doesn't have an option to get out of it and go into bear form. He has to just survive the stun lock, which Tempo Storm are trying to exploit that as the weak link. They've gotten his bar skin with the first stun. Now they're swapping to Blizzo and trying to make Looney panic with the smoke bomb. They make Looney jump in. Then they get a stun into a polymorph off the back of the smoke bomb. Tempo Storm play is looking great. Unfortunately, on this map, Botar is a lot easier to get to. It's just a close quarters. He's not going to have that much larger pillar as he had on the Grand to avoid them. And this is also a nice adaptation by XRB, hitting multiple targets when Botar gets too far away. Switch some of your attention to the Rogue. That forces Botar to come back. Now he has to deal with two targets at dangerously low health, and it's not a great position. He's caught into the stun, and he's also running Relentless. He's not able to get out of it. He's barely hanging on, but it's not enough. Perfect map selection, nice strategy adaptation by XRB to the Moon.
Find ourselves in a situation, it's all tied up, 1-1, XRB to the Moon versus Tempo Storm, and this is a matchup that we expect to go back and forth. The question is, can XRB break the script? Can they gain momentum and take away that advantage that Tempo Storm gained by getting the first win in this series?
I think it's important to take into account that Nixie won BlizzCon on the Windwalker Monk with Alex Mage, so they are very familiar with this composition, and they played it with a dampening style, which makes me expect them to do the same here on Tolvaron Arena. The Windwalker Monk just going to be rolling around, looking for those burst moments while the Mage crowd controls everyone and they elongate the match, and they're looking to try and win on mana, win in dampening against XRB to the Moon. But XRB to the Moon, they're the kings of dampening. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to out-dampen them.
I mean, this is a classic Alec, right? Like, he always thinks of these things, as we see a nice vortex coming in from Botar there. He always thinks of these strategies that someone else wouldn't necessarily think of. When you think of the Mage, you normally think of like going for the quick game, going for the kills. They've actually picked up a really nice strategy here. You can see they're definitely playing for that attrition war, playing for the long game. Botar already committing his tree form and innovate first few seconds of the game because he wants to stay offensive. And like we were calling out in the pregame, like Zico was saying, they can really burn down at the mana of Looney if they get the double stuns, get the damage, use Kleptomania with perhaps a counterspell or an incap over onto Looney. They'll generate create a lot of pressure, and Looney's constantly going to be catching up, but it's dependent on Nixie being able to kite out this damage here.
And another thing to take into account is that Windwalkers in Legion, when Nixie won, they had a lot of self-sustainability when they would portal away. That would allow them a big heal, and they had a lot of healing abilities in general. They don't have that. So the Windwalker Monk is a lot more vulnerable in this expansion, and that's why XRB to the Moon, they know that. So they're going after the weak link, which is the Windwalker. And right now, Nixie is not dealing with it to the best of his ability. He's doing his best, I guess, but he's forced all of his major defensive cooldowns at this point. He's trying to push in for another swap onto Looney. This is an aggressive play when he's already behind. Blizzo tries to punish with the Intimidating Shout on Botar. If Nixie can't get away, he could be going down very shortly.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely not looking great for Nixie, but he does have Botar on his back. You can see he's utilizing the fact that this is not only a composition pick from Tempo Storm, this is also a map pick from them. This is an entire kind of draft. They've decided on the biggest map in the pool, Tolvaron Arena, and Looney knows what the win conditions are here. You can see he's looking for drinks immediately in the game, getting up to full mana, not really scared of the incoming threat from Tempo Storm. And despite the fact Nixie's in trouble, with Botar backing him up with this big map, he should have the opportunities to kite, but he needs to be very careful, especially since he's without that Gladiator's Medallion right now.
Yeah, it's going to be a very scary moment on the next Stormbolt for Nixie. He's got that Touch of Karma coming up in 10 seconds, so he can trade that to prevent his own death. But he would like to hold on to that, I think, so he can stay aggressive, because the pressure that XRB to the Moon have forced Nixie to just be running away for most of this match. And if not, he gets stunned like this and takes a huge amount of burst. Botar doesn't have much to deal with it. Touch of Karma barely connecting, allowing Nixie to survive. If this kind of momentum stays in favor of XRB, I don't really see Tempo Storm taking this. They get Looney, but of course Looney, he's in bear form. He knows that swap is coming. Actually shapeshifted out of bear form on the stun. That was a pretty big blunder on Looney's part, and maybe cost him more cooldowns than otherwise. At the start of that chain, I was thinking, yeah, nice job, Looney, but ended up throwing it away a bit by shapeshifting out of bear form, and it cost him 2-for-1. Now there's a 25-second window that he could be in danger. Unfortunately, with Leg Sweep as the only stun on Windwalker, it's not going to be up in that window, so Nixie needs to extend the game even further.
I really like the way Botar's playing here. He's actually not using the Iron Bark on any situation where he thinks he doesn't need to use it. A lot of Druids would just kind of train it out on the Storm Bolts, especially since Nixie didn't have a trinket for that last one there, but instead he trades out the tree, trades out the Innovate. You can see both these Druids, such high caliber, sitting down for drinks constantly, understanding the entire flow of the game. But as dampening starts to stack, one of the big things that saved Looney in that last setup was the fact that Zeepi is just able to spam out those healing surges, the off-healing utility from the Enhancement Shaman. As dampening stacks, it's going to get more and more scary for Looney, and Nixie, if he can keep using the map to his advantage, keep kiting around, that's not affected by dampening.
I mean, I feel Tempo Storm, they need dampening to kill, basically. The only target that they can possibly take down is Looney, so before dampening, they make these swaps to Looney. It also puts him in a position where he might think that he's the target deep in dampening, but I think the Warrior is actually the kill target. This situation right now where Blizzo is 20%, if we're at 30% dampening, he's dead. So this is exactly what Tempo Storm needs to implement on. Their targeting is great, going between the Druid and the Warrior. I would like to see a bit more crowd control on Zeepi, maybe more Cyclones or Polymorphs, but I guess Botar doesn't want to give that potential away. If he moves forward for Cyclones like this, he can get switched to. Could be a risky move. Good crowd control from Blizzo. I really think that Blizzo is going to be using his utility a lot more to win the game, to end the game, rather than to delay it, because the longer they delay it, I feel the more favored Tempo Storm are going to get. They make a swap over to Botar. They caught him off guard. Is he playing that Feral Affinity is the question, because if he's not, it's going to be very difficult for him to recover from these swaps. And if XRB to the Moon steal the strategy that Tempo Storm are trying to implement, Botar could also be in danger in dampening.
It does look like he's running the Guardian Affinity. I'm pretty sure we saw the Frenzy Regeneration there. Of course, that's one of the big advantages of that Guardian Affinity. It's basically a heal. Heals for 25% of your health, as we see another swap over onto Looney right now. Nixie and Alec doing such a good job with these swaps. Zeepi, though, able to get out the off heals, keep his Resodruid alive. Another good Vortex on the Wild Charge coming out of Botar. Once again, these Druids, every single time their team goes offensive, all three members are on the same page. They all push in, they all help, however their classes can do so. One of the other things I do want to call out, though, is when they're doing these swaps to Looney and we see Blizzo come back to peel, that's actually where the AoE damage comes in from Alec and Nixie. Zeke in the pregame is talking about if they kind of cleave both the DPS. Actually, what they're doing is cleaving Blizzo and Looney, similar to what we saw in the Rogue Mage Priest game. And as dampening starts to stack, that's going to get more and more scary. Looney will struggle to keep up.
Yeah, and XRB to the moon, they've got an opening 50 seconds left on Botar's trinket. So if they go for a charge, storm bolt, huge swap to Botar, he could get caught off guard. And if Alec doesn't save him, ultimately go down. At the moment, it seems like XRB to the moon are switching their targeting quite a lot. They focused Nixie in the early game before dampening. Now they're trying to go after Alec. And I like this play better. Run at Alec, but attack Nixie while you're running at him. That way you're putting pressure on two targets. Nice swap by Nixie, catching Looney out of bear form there. That was a good play. This touch of death could be devastating. Blizzo saves the day, though, with a double intimidating shout. Alec is already on low health. XRB are trying to make it difficult for Botar to predict the targeting. They bash Botar out of that intimidating shout, make a swap, force his hand. Tree of Life used before we're at really of a critical mass. Botar has been using Tree of Life in a lot of these matchups, and I think he's probably one of the only rest of druids that does it. What the advantage of it could be is that in deep dampening, you pop that Tree of Life, that's a 30-second window of go time as a druid. You're just going to be doing so much healing that it's almost impossible to push you over. And when you're in deep dampening, you need that to keep your team sustained and stay in the face of your opponent. Looney's not going to have that big, powerful wave on his side, but he should have the mana advantage, but he's not even getting that. So it might just be that Botar is slightly ahead of the meta, realizing those kill windows in the matchups. If they can cycle to that second Tree of Life and then make a big push with it while they've got that 30-second window of basically, we're not going to die, I think Tempo Storm are going to be taking this.
Yeah, I mean, the Tree of Life brings a lot of things, right? But the Cultivation, which is presumably the time that Looney's running instead, it's not just mana efficiency, it's also just more healing. Like, it counts towards your mastery, gives you an extra 10% or so. We see big damage now, though, coming out by Tempo Storm. You're trading out that Frozen Orb once again. You could see how devastating that cooldown is every time. Available for Alec, of course, he's using his Blizzard to kind of reduce the cooldown of that orb as much as he can, because it is one of the big damage offensives for the Frost Mage. Whenever he can get it up, he's getting both of these targets down to about, you know, 60-50%, causing Looney a problem. And that's where the Tree of Life would potentially come in useful to catch up. With 20% dampening now, Botar looking very confident, has his trinket, has his bark skin, looking for a little bit of an offensive push here over onto Looney.
The one playstyle for Turbo in particular, so the Warrior Enhancement, is what I like to call the pinball strategy, where you're just bouncing off any target that gets near you as much as possible and trying to put as many targets behind. That's what XRB to the Moon are doing right now. They're pinballing between Alec and Nixie. Botar has to spend way more mana to heal two targets, and if he gets caught on the target that doesn't have Life Bloom, where all two people connect, he's in a lot of trouble. Nixie, on the other hand, is making swaps, so he tries to catch Looney out of bear form with that paralysis, then leg sweep him, such as this situation. It's a lot of pressure on Looney. Nice vortex from Botar. It might be a game-winning play. It's costing Looney a lot of cooldowns. If Nixie and Alec can stay on target a little bit longer, that Fist of Fury flying in, Looney manages to duck for cover and survive, but we stack in another 10% dampening. They don't make it out of that situation alive. So far, Tree of Life is cycling back up. Tempo Storm are going to have that for a big wave push later into the game. Looney is going to start feeling the heat soon.
Yeah, and they actually forced the Veiled Eye proc on Blizzo there as well, so that's not going to be up for the next couple of onslaughts coming in from Tempo Storm. This is starting to look fantastic for the roster. Botar sitting down for a drink. Nixie has that touch of karma, so he's going to be fine as well. Both of these healers now will be at full mana, and I think this is a huge advantage to Tempo Storm. You can see that Tree of Life cooldown we were talking about for Botar up in about 10 seconds here, and because of that, they're going to have the opportunity to get very offensive in the near future. Looney has his trinket. That's kind of the last line of defense for the team, but if you don't do enough healing, it's not going to be enough. We see Nixie pushing in. Maybe they're looking for a swap on Blizzard. They're a little bit indecisive here because Looney got that fantastic primitive bear form. They're going after Blizzard, though, Sid.
Yeah, as a single target, he's not in the most danger in this position. Looney deflects the attack quite easily. It seems like Tempo Storm, they've been overextending themselves there, and they really wanted to go after something, but they need to be hitting two targets at the same time. Double leg sweep on Zipai and Blizzo, or a double leg sweep on Blizzo and Looney, or a triple. Triple would be the best situation. That way, Alec can just shred into the entire team. If they're only going after one target, they're not fully taking advantage of the spread pressure of Fist of Fury and the spread pressure from Ice Nova and Cone of Cold from Frost Mage. So they want to make sure that they're at least hitting two targets on those burst windows. If they don't, Iron Bark, which is a cooldown the Restoration Druid has, it's 9 seconds, 8 seconds available for Looney again, is very effective at stopping damage on one target. So you need to make sure that you're hitting two. You can't use it on two members. So Tempo Storm just need to be patient, try and bait XRB to stack up, but XRB are making that difficult. That's why Blizzard is going on Nixie and Zipai is going on Alec. They spread themselves apart. They don't stack up for double stuns. Then they collide when they have a Stormbolt available. XRB are implementing an excellent strategy. Now they're making the swap, both colliding on Botar, but yeah, they've stacked up, double stun. This could be a swing in either team's favor as huge damage comes in on both sides.
Yeah, that was a big play there for Tempo Storm. Look at the pressure they're starting to generate now. Serenity committed. That was also a lot of damage from Alec. He still has his Icy Veins available. Oh, actually, sorry, he's running the Ice Form on the other side there, so he did use that. That was all the offensive. We see Touch of Death. They're trying to tunnel down Looney right now. He's really struggling to keep up. Nixie needs to be a little bit careful, though. Does have that Touch of Karma, but now that they've forced out the Barkskin and the Ironbark, if they can get another good swap over onto Looney, he won't have any of those damage mitigating cooldowns, and it could be a fantastic push, potentially a game-winning push for Tempo Storm.
I mean, both druids are in trouble. Botar's not going to see another Tree of Life. That allowed his team to be completely stable for that 30-second window, but they want to get a kill in that 30-second window, and they didn't get it. So now Botar will lose the sustain healing that Looney has with his talent decisions, which now puts the advantage in favor of XRB to the moon. Tempo Storm need to look to end this game as soon as possible, but there's no clear target. Everyone has Gladiator's Medallion on XRB to the moon side. They can get out of any incoming stuns and immediately trade defensive cooldowns. Looney in this situation can use the Gladiator's Medallion. He is trying to play the slower match by trading Barkskin, a much more efficient trade, but it's also risky at this high of dampening. As Blizzo now dips low, Tempo Storm are implementing that double target strategy. It's throwing Looney for a loop. He has to recover two targets at the same time. In the meantime, Botar getting spell reflected on a Cyclone, getting outplayed a bit there by Blizzo. It's going to put him a little bit behind. Blizzo's trying to punish that mistake and go after him.
Yep, Blizzo and Botar, former teammates. Blizzo gets the best of that exchange, though, this former Triforce squad. You can see the success they've had on these rosters as we're at 47% down, 47% healing reduction, but you're not doing any healing in that counterspell, Looney. Blizzo in trouble. Comet Storm comes crashing down from Alec as he's looking to end the game here. Kills off the grounding. Nixie in trouble. Does have that touch of karma, though. Looney once again manages to somehow, some way recover his team's health pool, but you can see the big cooldowns are coming up. Serenity's available. Ice Form's almost available. Tempo Storm will look for the kill with this next setup.
With how much healing Enhancement Shamans bring and how much control mages bring, basically both teams are playing the same strategy. Build up, save, and store all of your big burst damage, and then one single movement, one single swoop at high dampening when the other team can't recover, you just push all of it into their face. At this point, it could even result in a cross kill. Looney getting swapped to. He's trying to go for the efficient trade with Blizzo's support. It may be possible, but Blizzo's also dipping low. The double targeting strategy is working out for Tempo Storm. Dampening's at critical mass, and Looney will fall. Tempo Storm implementing great strategy here on game three.
Keep in mind, if you're like, wait, that's not what I'm experiencing on live, you have to think these guys have a little bit more Azeroth power than you may expect on live, but this could end it. We're on Ruins of Lordaeron. Tempo Storm leads by two.
It would be a fitting final resting place, as it is a cemetery. And the last time I really saw Botar and Looney go head-to-head in a turbo mirror was 2015.
Yep.
It's been 3 years since I've seen these teams go head-to-head in a mirror like this. And so far, momentum seems to be in favor of Tempo Storm. They're just doing a lot more damage.
Yeah, ironically, in 2015, Looney was actually playing with Jamie and Nixie, the Turbo Cleave. Now he's got Blizzo and ZPI on his team. And I mean, let's weigh this up pound for pound. Botar, Looney, you wouldn't put a bed there either way. Jamie has been playing Enhanced forever. ZPI, of course, known more for the Elemental Shaman. Blizzo's an absolute beast. I wouldn't necessarily weigh him down. But this is a very even matchup in terms of players. And once again, Tempo Storm, this was their counterpick in favor of XRB to the moon, and they've come out even the odds. They have a very reasonable game here, and we already saw what Jamie can do on that Enhancement Shaman. A lot of procs when you come in with those Storm Strikes is going to be absolutely fantastic damage. And I mean, if they can just get a gip here, they'll take the series.
I mean, right now it's just a brawl with four players just sitting on top of each other doing as much damage as possible. Neither team really can afford to move. If you're a Resto Druid and you start to cross the map to try and crowd control the other Druid, you're not casting regrowth and you're not healing, so you're falling behind as you cross the map. And basically both Druids are pinned down in one place because each team does so much damage. They see a swap here on Botar. They catch him out of form. He's forced to trinket. That's going to be a lead for XRB to the moon. If they can just stay on target, maybe Botar just falls over. They've managed to force his hand. So many defensive cooldowns on just one swap. They've still got pressure. Jamie's trying to support, but he's spending all of his maelstrom on healing, which means his damage is going to start to fall behind. This swap from XRB paid off immensely.
Yeah, not only that, it means you're cleaving everyone. Nixie disarmed. Khan uses Die by the Sword and ends up falling there. Beautiful play by Blizzard. And I mean, XRB still king of the turbo.
And you know, honestly, this has just been such an incredible series to watch. It deserves this game five to settle it. Tempo Storm has the advantage from winning the first game. XRB to the moon is going to have to play flawlessly. Who's going to take it? Tempo Storm or XRB to the moon? The winner of this has not dropped a single series in the tournament and will get the first place into the grand final.
XRB to the moon have been, I believe, undefeated in this season. So Tempo Storm are looking to be the first team to take them down as they rise back to power with Botar being brought in. It seems like they've breathed new life into their team. Momentum has been insanely in their favor. They're outthinking their opponents. Their strategy's on point. XRB to the moon are playing a lot more aggressive here in game number five, which is a risky decision against a composition that wants to stack targets up, but it might be ultimately the correct one. We saw deep in Dampening that they were more disadvantaged, so potentially running down the healer could be their only option.
I actually think playing aggressive is absolutely the right call for XRB to the moon in the early game, because Tempo Storm honestly has very little kill threat with this composition before later Dampening, and because of that, XRB to the moon should try it. You know, maybe they catch Botar. He has no trinket, no bark skin from that first onslaught. If they can catch him in the Storm Bolt, perhaps into a DR bash from Looney, that can easily be the game right there and then. So definitely got to respect the incoming pressure from the Turbo Cleave. They're really tunneling down Botar. They catch him out of form here. Battle Stance on Blizzo. They're going for this DR cap totem. Now we'll see that counter pressure you're talking about, Sid, with the Frozen Orb from Tempo.
Yeah, Z-Pi will be under fire as well as Blizzo. I like that Tempo Storm are adapting to XRB's adaptation. If you're going to run at our healer, then we're going to go after your DPS members because they're going to overextend and line of sight your healer. So this is a nice move on both teams. XRB to the moon implements a new strategy. Tempo Storm receive it and they adapt instantly. And this is the highest level of play you're going to see in Arena. Neither team really tunnel visioning into any strategy in particular, trying to mix it up and keep the other team on their toes. Now we see Blizzo going after Nixie, trying to force Botar to switch his HOTS onto a different target and more likely to catch him out of bear form as well. This is just top level play.
You actually saw Botar go for a cheeky little stealth then. One of the things I want to call out, because obviously in Legion, when you saw mages and druids playing defensively, they would go for this kind of like spamming out the polymorphs into the cyclones, but it's actually not necessarily beneficial for Tempo Storm because Botar wants to keep his mana high, and one of the things people don't necessarily know about Battle for Azeroth is that Cyclone actually costs more mana than a spell like Regrowth, for example. So you want to be kind of being conservative with your mana. If you don't need the Cyclone, it's often better to just kind of kite away in these situations, and Botar doesn't need to win the game right now. He knows that he'll win if he gets to, you know, 40, 50, 60% dampening healing reduction. That's what he's playing for, and he's just playing it defensively, utilizing that big map perfectly.
Yeah, as you said, Tempo Storm's goal is to just survive. Stay alive as long as possible, get to the highest amount of dampening you can, and then look for a double kill on either Blizzo Looney or Z-Pi Blizzo. That's the main objective for Tempo Storm strategically. They've brought the best snaring class in the game, Frostmage. It's going to be making it almost impossible for Blizzo or Z-Pi to attack a target. Blizzo's, interestingly enough, gone for the gnome race so he can get escape artist, so he can get out of snares and roots more effectively. That's a nice strategy choice on his part against that of a frost mage. But they've also paired it up with a windwalker monk, which is one of the highest mobility melee in the game and is reasonably self-sustainable if he can cast a fuse on himself, or vivify, I believe now, behind a pillar. So but Tempo Storm have just crafted this composition that you can't catch. It drags it out into deep dampening and then goes for a giant wave of damage with Touch of Death and Comet Storm. And at 50% dampening, you're not going to survive that wave. So Tempo Storm strategically are favored in this matchup. XRB to the moon are trying to find a way to get around all of that kiting potential. And the only real strategy they have is going after Botar and trying to chase the healer down and force him to make a mistake. But if Botar doesn't choke, I think Tempo Storm are taking this.
Yeah, I think Tempo Storm most likely wins the day. The race as we go further into dampening. But one of the things I do like about the XRB strategy is that if Blizzo actually uses more of his peels on Alec or just damage on Botar, it means he's never going to get cleaved on those swaps to Looney, right? And that was the way they actually won the last game. I mean, yes, it was a little bit of like they did kill Looney at the end of the game, but the reason he came out of form in the first place is because he had to hop Blizzo. Blizzo was also at about 10% at the end of that one. If Blizzo uses his Storm Bolts on Alec, uses his peels there, it could be much better.
This is the highest level of resto druid play you really get to see. When you're getting attacked and trained down like this as a druid, you can sometimes escape out of line of sight and very far away and go into stealth. then your opponents can't see you to attack you. And you don't really think about that in the middle of a game, like, hey, I could go into stealth as a healer. And both Looney and Botar are doing this whenever they can. In the meantime, there is good pressure on Looney. This is a nice setup by Tempo Storm, managing to force Barkskin. I'm wondering if Nixie is now going to adapt to the strategy and just tunnel Looney, and this could end up being a healer race as dampening has set in. This is the what the Tempo Storm have been playing for. That red number at the start of your or top of your screen, that number reduces the effectiveness of healing. So Tempo Storm want to stack that number up and survive as until it's as high as possible, really, so that when they go for that big wave of damage, Looney simply can't recover through it. XRB are racing to take Botar down before that giant wave hits them.
Yeah, you can see actually Looney, if you look at the Twitch extension, he swapped away from the Cyclone in this matchup, actually favoring the Overgrowth talent, which is a smart pick against the Frost Mage, because Frost Mage is one of the things they'll try to do when they get aggressive, or any spec of Mage really, is they'll Kleptomania you in the stun, which removes all of the high healing over time effects from the Restoration Druid, which is basically what the Restoration Druid uses to heal. So with Overgrowth, you can reapply all of those hots immediately. You get your Regrowth, your Rejuve, and your Life Bloom. And he's also playing the Focus Growth, which is obviously efficiency and just more healing on the Life Bloom. So I really like this choice coming out of Looney. You can see he's healing it very efficiently at this point. We're still 8% dampening. So Tempo Storm, if it's anything like the last game, it was 51% dampening. So we're still a few minutes away from that there. And Botar, like you said, Sid, he's been tunneled by ZPI this entire game. A lot of Resto Druids would really struggle with the high damage coming out of enhancements, especially after the buff. But Botar's just kiting constantly, stealthing, doing whatever he needs to do.
That was a nice play by Looney, that Ursul's Vortex. Botar thought he was safe, so he wild charged to his partner. Ursul's Vortex pulled him right back in range of Blizzo and ZPI, and he had to use his Gladiator's Medallion. So now he can't use that to break out of a stun for a 2-minute window. XRB to the Moon have 2 minutes now where they can cleanly set up on Botar for a kill. He's going to have to be even more laser focused than he already has with Blizzo and ZPI gunning him down. The one thing I really want to highlight with Blizzo is normally we think of Bladestorm, especially Rich, I'm sure. Bladestorm's the big damage ability. You want to be hitting people with that. But instead, in this matchup against a mage, you use Bladestorm to get to your target because it removes snares and novas, as well as Avatar does the same. Blizzo's been doing a great job cycling through those to stay and get good uptime. It's just top-notch level play on his part. They get good pressure on Nixie. They make a swap to Botar. When Nixie falls behind, this is in the 2-minute window. Is Botar going to fall? He just jumps out. Alex's side, Ursul's Vortex not available, but ZPI has Ascendance. He's attacking Botar from ranged. Is that going to be enough damage to push him over? Blizzo charges. They need to kill him. They've got another minute to do it. If they don't manage to kill Botar before that Gladiator's Medallion is up, I don't know when they're going to. They set up for a swap to Nixie. They've kept good pressure, and this is exactly what you need to do against a Restoration Druid. Have pressure on two targets. Make it difficult for him to recover. You're more likely to catch him in this situation where he's not in bear form. They're still in that minute kill window. Nice Sunder. XR move in. Botar hangs on by a thread, jumps over to Alex. Blizzo in hot pursuit. They chop him up right before.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered in the middle of history the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.